With mounting pressure from the governor and other fellow Democrats, State Senator Martin Sandoval has resigned as chairman of the Senate's Transportation Committee.
And we've just learned of another resignation as the fallout from this federal corruption probe continues. WGN's Megan Dwyer joins us now with the very latest. Megan?
Dina, Joe, up front, we want to say nobody yet has been charged with any wrongdoing. They might never be. But we're certainly learning more about this probe today. It has now entangled state agencies, various politicians, and some big corporations. And tonight, a new resignation from the Tollway Board.
Corruption and self-dealing are unacceptable and will be rooted out, whether it's in my administration or in the legislature.
Cesar Centoy, an alderman in Berwyn, was appointed by Governor Pritzker to the Illinois Toll Highway Authority in February.
It's important for us to make sure that there is no cloud that is carried over any of the work that gets done at the tollway. And so, as I say, he should step aside.
Hours later, he did. He is now the second politician to step down from a leadership position since reporters obtained this unredacted federal search warrant today. Executed last month at Senator Sandoval's Springfield office, it shows the FBI was looking for evidence of federal corruption, including bribery, theft from a federally funded program, mail and wire fraud, and interference with commerce by threats or violence, specifically items related to any official action taken in exchange for a benefit. State Senator Martin Sandoval didn't give a reason for stepping down today. He just wrote this letter, which read, quote, "I am resigning as chairperson for the Senate Transportation Committee."
He's overseeing a $45 billion road construction project. Can you imagine that? And this is a guy who the feds just raided his offices 2 weeks ago.
He still retains his seat and remains a top Democrat in the Senate. The unredacted warrant mentions specific officials who work for ComEd Exelon and the Illinois Department of Transportation, a red light camera vendor in the suburbs, and high-profile gambling operators, some who have been trying to get a horse race track and casino up and running in Tinley Park. The corruption probe has named several communities in Sandoval's district like Cicero, and it's named politicians like Jeff Tobolsky, the mayor of McCook, Stephen Landeck, a state senator and the mayor of Bridgeview, and John Harris, Rod Blagojevich's former chief of staff. The list of items the FBI took from Sandoval's Springfield office includes computers, cell phones, shredded paper, documents related to his personal business, a fundraising spreadsheet, and a flash drive with the word Landeck written on it. State Senator Landeck did not return a call for comment, neither did the mayor of McCook. Santoy's attorney told the Chicago Tribune Santoy is not a target of this probe. The FBI simply wanted some records, and he is confident these legal concerns will clear up very soon.
All right. Thanks, Megan.
We'll see.